हाय हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग. दिस इज वाई आर के मोहन, केमिस्ट्री फैकल्टी. श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई केम विथ डिफरेंट वीडियोस इन द लास्ट क्लास फॉर ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री. हेलो ऑल्केन्स एंड हेलो एरियंस. बट टुडे आई वुड लाइक टू अगेन रिमाइंड फ्यू थिंग्स अबाउट व्हाट आई डिस्कस्ड इन द लास्ट क्लास. Rapidly revision. After that, I will come back to the latest updates. So, last class I have discussed about the classification of halogen compounds, and then in the classification I have told what is the names of the compounds, as well as I discussed about the nature of CX bond. Since halogen atoms are more electronegative, and I explained about partial negative charge development over the halogen and partial positive charge over carbon atom because of the electronegativity differences. After that, explained about some reactivity tendencies and some methods of preparation we have started. We have also shown with a flowchart. The same thing today I would like to again present you with a different way of presentations. That is, I'd like to show you the preparation of haloalkanes from alkanes by the direct halogenation, methane chlorination mechanism, iodination mechanism, reaction with the SO2 Cl2, as well as from most important reactions what we discussed in the previous session also, from alcohols, how can you prepare these haloalkanes using Groves method, and also by the action of phosphorus halides on the alcohols, how can prepare haloalkanes we are going to discuss, and the action of thionyl chloride over alcohols, the Dargens method also most important, we are going to discuss it in today's present class. And silver salts of fatty acids reactions and some named reactions, and finally from halogen exchange methods also discussed in this will be discussed in this session of the classes. Let us move on to the first part of it. I have first point is nothing but from alkanes. From alkanes, how you will prepare haloalkanes? Let us see. By the direct halogenation of alkanes in the presence of sunlight, heat or suitable catalyst yields alkyl halides. And there is a chemical reaction here shown. In this chemical reaction we have RH means that is alkane, X2 is halogen, or the aroma mark H nu is shown, RX plus HX. This is the chemical reaction which is indicating the preparation of haloalkanes. Moreover, halogenation of methane is the most important one in this. One of the most important chemical reaction of alkanes is this halogenation of methane, which is defined as the replacement of hydrogen atom of the molecule by halogen atom. And in this mixture of haloalkanes and chlorine remains unaffected in the dark. Why? Because the reaction is vigorous reaction occurs when it is exposed to light only at a high temperature. As pointed above, the reaction takes place a free radical mechanism. We proceeds in the following three steps. The one step in this free radical mechanism is called a chain initiation. The second one is chain propagation, chain termination. That is the chain initiation, how it takes place. The chain initiation takes place by the formation of chlorine free radical. Then after, in this free radical reaction, now we have some thermodynamic analysis is there. It indicates that delta H is equals to plus 58 kilocalories per mole. It is an endothermic process. And coming to the second one, the chain propagation reaction. The chain propagation reaction, we have this, whatever the free radical obtained in the initiation is going to attack on halogen, and the alkane gives methyl free radical, and it is said to be exothermic reaction from this delta H value. The propagation step, we have second one, this methyl free radical combines with halogen chlorine forms methyl chloride haloalkane. And also one chlorine free radical is going to be generated, which is also considered as one exothermic process. Let us see the chain termination step of the final step of the reaction. mechanism. That is, chlorine-chlorine free radicals unites to give chlorine, and as well as methyl free radical and chlorine free radical combines to form methyl chloride is halo alkane chloro methane. Even some methyl free radicals are said to be combined with each other, another methyl free radical to form ethane in this process. So this is one of the fundamental of this halogenation reactions of methane, which is root cause of formation of haloalkanes. Let us see what is going to happen in the ease of substitution of various carbon atoms of the order tertiary, greater than secondary, greater than primary, which is same as the study of stability of various alkyl halides. So this is most important point to be noted. And coming to another point, what I am going to present you is bromination of alkanes has close similarities to chlorination, except the rate of reaction which is slow. That is why it is not easy. Fluorination of alkanes is a violent reaction, so we cannot easily conduct, but it results the cleavage of carbon-carbon bond as well as carbon-hydrogen bonds. The potential energy curve of this halogenation of chlorine is one of the most important one for the understanding of haloalkanes formation from methane. In this, we have a graphical representation with two peaks, the RH plus Cl dot, whatever shown here in the lower energy level, it goes up to a maximum level. Then after, it is reducing energy as it is noticed as endothermic reaction. After that, again one more exothermic reaction shown in the graphical representation. Finally, the formation of chloromethane or alkyl halide is giving lower energy in this graphical representation, indicates that we have haloalkane which is obtained in this reaction is stable. Let us see the next one. Move on to some of the important chemical reactions of ethane, propane, butane, how they undergo chlorination reactions or halogenation reactions. Let us see, if you maintain the proportion of alkane and halogen, you can easily get the haloalkane monochloro ethane in this reaction we have shown in the presence of light, it is happening. Come to the next one, this what we called as ethane, and we obtained a product called as ethyl chloride is the major product in this reaction. Another reaction, if you see in this reaction, we have taken propane, and propane undergoes halogenation reaction, chlorination reaction gives 2 chloro propane and 1 chloro propane. In this 2 chloro propane is the 55% of product which is major product, and 1 chloropropane is 45% which is minor product. Even we have butane chemical reaction also shown in this. We have a racemic mixture is obtained, N-butane racemic mixture, optically inactive racemic mixture which is obtained in this halogenation. This is one of the important reaction we have observed. And reaction with SO to Cl2. So this is called as sulfuryl chloride. Here in this previous session also we mentioned here, sulfuryl chloride is in the absence of light and catalyst does not react with alkanes, gives boiling points, even at the boiling points. So, but in the presence of sunlight and trace amounts of organic peroxide, this reaction is noticed as the fast reaction. We have shown the same equation in the previous session. RH plus SO2 Cl2 gives rise to RCl plus SO2 plus HCl. So here in the present session also we have one same equation we have mentioned, a peroxide. That peroxide may be organic peroxide, benzoyl peroxide can be taken in this reaction. Let us move to the next one. From alkanes, how you will prepare this haloalkanes? Let us see. Morponic of addition of HX. So as we know that what is morponic of product? So two product, whatever the two halo alkane, two halo alkane, whatever is there, the two halo alkane according to morponic of reaction or mechanism, which is the major product as the carbocation is stable in that process. So let us see. Addition of HX. Hydrogen halide or halogen acids reacts readily with alkanes to form alkyl halides. And this reactivity is HA greater than HBr greater than HCl, so on. A simple chemical reaction, ethene, how it reacts with hydrogen bromide, shown, ethyl bromide is formed. But in this addition of HX to alkane is electrophilic addition reaction, that's why it takes place according to Markovnikov rule, which is giving a clarity about its definition. That is, an ionic addition of an unsymmetrical reagent to a double bond, the positive part of the reagent attaches itself to a carbon atom of double bond so as to yield more stable carbocation as intermediate. So this step determines the overall orientation of the reaction. That step. And moreover, what we can learn more about this Markovnikov rule of formation of halo alkanes is the reaction on which reagent rearrangement of carbocation occurs. The overall addition of HX to alkene does not follow Markovnikov rule, but in case of both alkene and the adding reagent are unsymmetrical, then there is a possibility of not only one product, there are two products are possible. One is minor, one is major products are possible. So minor product means that percentage of the yield will be less. Major product means percentage of yield is more. We have taken definite examples in this. Here I have shown two halo alkane is an example only for some kind of chemical reaction. So let us move on to the next chemical equation part of Markovnikov's rules. Important chemical equations related to Markovnikov. So I have taken propene with HBr and the reaction is giving 2-bromopropane. This is what I called as 2-haloalkane. So what we obtained here is 2-bromopropane. So 2-bromopropane is nothing but a stable carbocation formation in the process. 2-bromopropane. So I have told that is nothing but 2-haloalkane. Now in this reaction we have shown 2-bromopropane. Okay, let us see another one. What is the next chemical equation in this slide? We have taken a double bonded compound, but on the second carbon we have methyl is there. This we can call it as 2-methylpropene. If it reacts with HBr, what will happen? In this we have a carbon which is having less number of hydrogens, is not having hydrogens middle carbon, so it can easily attack by halogen and we will get the 2-bromo product here, that is called as 2-bromo-2-methylpropane. In the previous sessions also we have shown the same information regarding the Markovnikov rule here, and in the addition of halogen acids unsymmetrical alkene, generally Markovnikov rule is followed. The addition occurs through an electrophilic attack. This is what we have shown here. Electrophilic means in this we have H plus ion is electrophile, that is attacking. Initially electrophile will be attacked, then after halogen comes onto the stable carbon. That is called as the theme of the Markovnikov rule. Let us see one more example. In this example I am taking a 3-methylbutene, but1-ene. So I got a product, the product is also stable one as 2-bromo-2-methylbutene. But here the unsaturated carbon is not linked with the halogen. Do remember and please identify and concentrate what is the change taking place in this mechanism is the change is nothing but shifting of this hydrogen as hydride into the another part of the carbon chain in this example showing that this is called as hydride shift and finding the most stable carbocation in the mechanism. So let us see what is that hydride shift. The reason of 3-methyl-1-butene is nothing but its reaction is nothing but with HBr is 1-2 hydride shift. Let us see. This is nothing but 3-methyl-1-butene plus HCl, HBr, and Br is removed, and proton, whatever is there, electrophile H plus ion, attacks on this unsaturated carbon with less number of hydrogens. We got a secondary carbocation. But secondary carbocation, whatever obtained here, is not said to be stable. That's why it is finding its stability by the concept called as hydride shift. If it proceeds, what will happen? If it proceeds with secondary carbocation, what will happen? You will get 2-bromo-3-methyl butane, which is not the major product. Why? Because we have a carbon with halogen. With this carbon is secondary carbocation, which is not stable. But in this example of hydride shift, we got a carbocation which is more stable carbocation. Then after the halogen attack is giving major product 2-bromo-2-methyl-butene. So that is the most important point to be noted. Similarly, you can continue with the different examples like 3,3-dimethyl-butene with hydrogen bromide. How it involves methyl shift we call. That means the secondary carbocation is giving unstable minor products and tertiary carbocation is giving major products. So, secondary carbocation is giving that one. This is tertiary carbocation. Secondary carbocation is changing into tertiary carbocation is called as methyl shift. And after that, the halogen attack takes place on the tertiary carbocation. The halide takes place. So, this is called as most important change takes place in this Markovnikov rule. But now, Markovnikov rule is not telling about the shift. But Markovnikov rule is telling about the attack of halogen takes place on the carbon, unsaturated carbon, which is having very less number of or less number of hydrogens. But that takes place then after rearrangement. For the rearrangement, Markovnikov rule is not given any kind of instructions. So we need to find the stability concepts also. So let us move on to the phenyl shift cases. So 3-methyl-3-phenyl-butanoene with hydrogen bromide involves 1-2 phenyl shift. So in this phenyl shift also we have shown secondary carbocation as per the Markovnikov rule. But rearrangement giving stable compounds, so the rearrangement is giving tertiary carbocation, and that tertiary carbocation is giving the final major product in this Markovnikov reactions of haloalkanes. So let us move to another corner of Markovnikov rule. If Markovnikov rule is happened in the presence of peroxides with HBr, that is called as peroxide effect or Farage effect, or you can simply call it as anti-Markovnikov rule. So what do you mean by this anti-addition of HBr? Addition of HBr is easy addition while compared to others. Why? Because the other reactions with HBr, HCl and HI, these are said to be exothermic reactions, difficult to conduct. So this is the reason. Now let us see anti-Markovnikov rule statement. Addition of HBr to unsymmetrical alkenes in presence of organic peroxide such as benzyl peroxide is an anti-Markovnikov product, that is one product. That means earlier we discussed about a carbon chain. If this is the carbon chain, here suppose a double bond is there. Whatever halogen is there, the halogen is going to take place on the unsaturated carbon which is having even which is not having less number of hydrogens, which is having stable form of carbon free radical, stable form of carbon free radical. Suppose if you take this type of examples, here what will happen? This halogen is going to attack on this carbon, first carbon, not second carbon. So this is what the discussed in the anti-Markovnikov rule. That's why the product in the Markovnikov rule is secondary product. The product in the anti-Markovnikov rule is the one product, that means primary product. Let us see. It may be noted that peroxide effect applies to the addition of HBr only, not to the addition of HCl and HI. So we got here one bromopropane with propene, unsymmetrical alkene. And chain initiation step of this one is actually giving the free radicals, that is peroxide free radicals or alkoxy free radicals, we can call it as. The peroxide is breaking up into alkoxy free radicals. Alkoxy free radicals combines with HBr forms alcohol and bromine free radical. Then after this, bromine free radical is going to take part on the unsaturated carbon free radical. That means the free radical which is stable, finding that stability of the free radical, will finish this anti-Markovnikov rule. So secondary carbon free radical is said to be more stable than primary carbon free radical. Because of this reason only, anti-Markovnikov rule is giving one halo products. So termination reaction, halogen is forming and halo alkane is also forming. So in HBr, both the chain propagation reactions are exothermic, while that of in HCl and HA, the first steps are said to be endothermics, or the steps which are absorbing more energy than releasing. So this is the reason behind not taking HCl, HA in the anti-Markovnikov rule. Let us see. From alcohols, action of halogen acids. So this also we have discussed in the previous session. Here see, from alcohols, we have discussed the alcohol reacts with phosphorus trichloride, phosphorus pentachloride, even phosphorus, red phosphorus with iodine iodide formed, and this alcohol with thionyl chloride gives RCl, ROH alcohol with concentrated HCl and anhydride ZnCl2 is giving this RCl. These are actual general methods of preparation of this haloalkanes. Let us see the regular present session. So in this, alkyl halides prepared from alcohols by the replacement of OH by an halogen, that we will call it as halogen atom. That we will call it as substitution nucleophilic reaction. In this reaction, the nucleophile attacks the protonated alcohol molecule with the elimination of water. So we have shown the mechanism. In this mechanism, oxygen is responsible for taking this proton H plus ion and giving this oxonium ion in the first step. Oxonium ion is providing the removal. That means oxonium ion is the center for the removal of water. And finally, this halogen unites with this alkyl group, forms haloalkane in this action of halogen acids. So it can be noted that passing halogen acid or hydrogen chloride gas through alcohol in presence of anhydrous zinc chloride, we will get chloroethane. Mixture of concentrated HCl and anhydrous ZnCl2, whatever obtained in this is called as Lucas reagent. So this Lucas reagent treatment with alcohol is said to be Grue's process. Okay, let us see. The least reactive hydrogen halide, HCl generally requires the presence of ZnCl2 for the reaction with primary and secondary alcohols. However, highly reactive tertiary alcohols do not require any kind of presence of ZnCl2. So Lucas reagent is not required for tertiary alcohols. Tertiary alcohols are very reactive and therefore they react readily with concentrated HCl even in the presence of ZnCl2. See, tertiary alcohol I have taken with HCl, that tertiary alcohol I have taken is 2-methyl 2-propanol HCl I have taken, but I have not taken anhydrous ZnCl2. The reason is nothing but this tertiary alkyl halides reacts rapidly with the concentrated HCl at room temperature. But in the previous slide, whatever we have shown, this primary alcohol, ethyl alcohol with HCl, we have shown anhydrous ZnCl2. So Anhydrous ZnCl2 is not required in the case of tertiary alcohol treatment with concentrated Cl. So that is not said to be Lucas reagent. So reaction takes place with tertiary alcohol rapidly. That's why turbidity takes place rapidly. That turbidity is nothing but 2-chloro-2-methylpropane tertiary butyl chloride formed in this reaction. What about the bromides? Let us see. What about the bromides? I have shown in the previous session also, bromides can be prepared from phosphorus, red phosphorus, bromine and all. Even in this session, we are going to provide you the allyl bromide formations first. Then after, we are going to provide whatever the discussion of alkanes with the bromine combination. Okay. So let us see allyl bromide. Alkyl bromides are obtained in a similar manner, reflecting with alcohol with constant boiling HBr, 48% in the presence of little concentrated sulfuric acid. So ethyl alcohol taken, we got bromoethane and it's tested for concentrated. The primary alcohol only heated with the mixture of KBr and the presence of concentrated HCH2SO4 in excess of its alkyl bromide. It's a lab method actually. You can also prepare using potassium bromide and concentrated H2SO4 mixture with ethyl alcohol to get bromoethane. Let us see alkyl iodide formation. Here in previous session we have shown iodide formation, how iodide formation takes place. Alkyl iodides are prepared by reflexing alcohol with excess of hydrogen iodide, 75%. And these are also obtained when the alcohol is heated with the potassium iodide in the presence of phosphoric acid. So here phosphoric acid shown, potassium iodide, ethyl alcohol gives iodoethane. Let us see by the action of phosphorus halides. So phosphorus, all the phosphorus halides reactions and all we have mentioned in the previous class also with a flow chart here and detailed reactions here with the X we have shown, X is nothing but halogen, phosphorus trichloride, 3 moles of alcohol is required, phosphorus pentachloride, we need 1 mole of alcohol is enough in the reaction. Alkyl iodides and bromides can be obtained by treating alcohol with red phosphorus iodine or bromine to get Ri or RBr respectively. Here in the previous session in the flowchart we have shown red phosphorus plus Br2 that produces PBr3 or red phosphorus with I2 that produces Pi3. So in that manner we can prepare bromides and iodides, phosphorus bromides and phosphorus iodides to react with alcohols. Let us move on to the next one, that is thionyl chloride reaction, action of thionyl chloride. This we called as Dodgen's method. So alkyl chlorides are prepared when the thionyl chloride and alcohol are reflexed in presence of pyridine. So when you know pyridine is nothing but one of the aromatic compound as well as organic solvent to do such type of reactions. So in this thionyl chloride reaction, an advantage in that, but SO2 and HCl both are byproducts which are gases easy to remove. This is the reason we can say that thionyl chloride, Dodgen's method with thionyl chloride is said to be the most important one, and we get alkyl halide with the purest form. So for whatever the yield is there, yield purity will be more in this reaction. Coming to the fourth one, from silver salts of fatty acids. You know, carboxylic acid salt, silver. Carboxylic acid salts, the named reaction of this one is called as Borodin-Hunsaker reaction. Alkyl chlorides or bromides are prepared by the action of chlorine or bromine, NCCl4, on silver salt of fatty acids. So we have a chemical reaction in this RCOOAg plus Br2 gives HCCl4 reflex RBr plus CO2 plus AgRq. The same thing we have discussed in the previous session also, that is Borodin-Hunsaker reaction. Can see this here. Come to the present slide. But iodide forms ester instead of alkyl halide. Such reaction is called as Birnbaum-Simonini reaction. So that is a separate named reaction, but that reaction is not going to produce haloalkane. That produces ester. So that's why what we will do is we will mix the iodine with some of the lead acetate salts and all on the silver salts of carboxylic acids called fatty acids to get the alkyl iodides. Let us see the another method, that is called as bihalogen exchange methods. The first and most important method in this category is called as Finkelstein reaction. We have shown Finkelstein reaction in the previous session also, that Finkelstein reaction is nothing but alkyl bromate reaction sodium iodide in the presence of acetone or methyl alcohol. Acetone or methyl alcohol to give alkyl iodides, bromides reaction sodium iodide. So displacement, it's a matter of exchanging. Already halo alkane is formed, but in the halo alkane the halogen must be other than iodide, then we can easily conduct this reaction called as Finkelstein reaction to get iodo alkanes. This is the Finkelstein reaction. This reaction is called Finkelstein reaction. Swartz reaction. Let us say Swartz reaction. What is Swartz reaction? It is actually the preparation of fluoroalkanes. There is no other method which is discussed earlier is useful for the preparation of fluoroalkanes. But Swartz reaction is taking the help of fluorinating agents like silver fluoride, arsenic fluoride, or antimony fluoride, mercury fluoride, mercurous fluorides to react with this chloroalkanes or bromoalkanes to give fluoroalkanes. Means fluorine, as said earlier, it's a vigorous reactions. Even it breaks the carbon hydrogen carbon carbon bonds in the whatever the halo alkanes. So that fluorine indirectly, how we are taking in this Swartz reaction is nothing but we are taking the fluorine in the form of mercurous fluoride, antimony fluoride, arsenic fluoride, silver fluoride, etc. Anything you can take in this to get this type of alkyl fluorides. Thank you, dear friends, and thank you very much. These are all things we have discussed in the previous session also. In the previous session, we have discussed so many things with flowchart manner. But in this session, we have discussed elaborately about all these things. Thank you very much for watching my video. We are definitely going to present the excellent videos for the students who are going to prepare for competitive examinations as well as theory examinations for in chemistry case particularly. Okay, thank you. Namaskaram.